real simple. Let me get two actors out, two actors to start this out. Jonathan and Mondo. And we're going to play a little game, but first I need a... did any of you hear an interesting line, either on the radio, on TV, or from someone who said at work or something? Just one interesting line of dialogue, interesting sentence. Make America great again. I'm not sure what could have triggered that, but we're going to go with that. This game is actually called First Line, Last Line, and every time someone's going to cut in, it'll start a new scene, completely brand new scene, based on the last line of dialogue you heard from the scene that came before it. And that's why we call this First Line, Last Line.
Make America great again?
Again?
Yeah.
Didn't we do that the first time?
We did, but remember, first it was make Venezuela. It didn't work out so well.
Yeah, but we tried.
Well, okay, now it's make America great.
So it's make again. America, comma, great again.
If you're gonna write for this show, you've gotta be able to put your punctuation in the correct.
If you're gonna write for this show, you're gonna be able to put punctuation in the correct places. Did you study English?
I did try, but it's not
a writer for Comedy Central. Come on, man. Step up your game.
I'm not good at speaking.
I done try.
You done try.
Okay. Punchline.
I need the best up there.
Okay.
That's something we can work on.
You are the best.
You are the best.
You are the best.
You really are. And I'm sorry that it took me so long to tell you this.
I'm so happy to be with you.
I love it when your face mushes against mine.
Oh, can we just spend the rest of our lives together?
Of course, that's why I brought you here, under the moon, with that one pine tree. Listen, Sally.
This is such a romantic place.
After 6 months of dating, I feel like it's the perfect time for me to ask you for marriage. And papers.
It's just that I have this one thing. I have a secret.
I have a secret.
A secret, Shirley?
And I'm not going to tell you.
You're not going to tell me?
No. But it's a really good one. So trust me. But if you want to know.
Yeah, of course I want to know.
Someone else will tell you.
Someone, like Mom?
No.
I'm just going to
better.
Uncle Tom?
Even better.
I can't believe we're pacing in our spacious living room.
Well, that's what I have to talk to you about. Our interior designer is going to be at your party!
No!
Yes!
My M&M party!
Yes!
You know
the
how obsessed
color
I am!
Is going to be so spot on!
Oh my god!
I know!
I'm literally-
And it won't melt in your mouth.
And it won't melt in your mouth.
Teresa,
Bobby,
I've been looking for something that will last forever.
Look no further, Bobby. You found it here in the comfort of your own home.
I did. After searching endlessly on the internet,
I found my one true love.
Steve.
Things are a lot shorter than I thought. You said you'd be 7'2" in your...
So what, you were looking for a giant?
Well...
I'm 5'5", is that not enough woman for you? What do you want, a man? A
we did.
5'5", is that not enough woman for you?
And that's First Line, Last Line.
Where is she?
You know what her problem
is.
I need coffee. Okay. I have a serious problem here. Our office mate, Gabby, she's always late to work. She comes in with the craziest excuses, and she's gonna get fired. We need some help because no one believes her. We need a really good excuse for why she's not at work on time today. Come on. Help us, somebody. A really good excuse for why she's not here.
Diarrhea.
She's
got diarrhea. Yes. That's a great reason.
And let's think of a really creative way that she got to work. Like, what is a good excuse for how you got to work today?
Dinosaur.
She rode a dinosaur.
So she had diarrhea.
She got to work.
On a dinosaur.
All right, so everybody at the same time, let's go. Come back in!
Come back in!
Back to that kindergarten we used to have those letters all around the school, all that cool fun stuff. We're going to play a little game that really freaked out some of our students. These two had a more than capable mastery of it and were willing to do it on stage, so let's see how this goes. Let me get a location, any location.
Cuba.
Hawaii and Cuba. Well, they're both islands, I guess. I'm going to go with Hawaii, and Hawaii starts with the letter H. So this scene's going to take place in Hawaii. And they're going to start the scene with the letter H. The first line of dialogue is going to start with the letter H. Every line after that is going to go the next letter in the alphabet. So we're going to go H all the way to the Z, then back to A. And when we get back to H, we'll end again. And that's why we call this game Alphabet.
Honey.
It's nice.
Just because we didn't go all the way to Mexico and we came to Hawaii instead doesn't mean I need a long face, okay?
Knowing that you'd be like this, I ordered us tickets.
Let me find out that you put them on my credit card because I'll be so upset.
My love, this is our honeymoon. We're a thing now. It's gonna be like this.
No, do not give me that shit, okay?
Of course, I should have thought of that.
Please, don't tell me that you're gonna have this long face this whole entire time, okay? I'm drinking my Mai Tai on the beach, and the last thing I need is you.
Quiet. You listen to me. When I chose this destination, it's because we needed a place to go. Now, you've already been everywhere. You're all over the place. You're a big movie star. I get it. I'm sorry I'm not as lavish as other people, but this is what I could afford.
Really, honey? Well, in that case, it's all right, then. Tommy, one second, you're being sweet, and then the next second, you're fucking, what are you doing?
I don't know. I'm trying my best here. And you're just so ungrateful.
Vicky got the best treatment when you was dating her, but then here I am, and you don't even give a fuck.
Well, Vicky's dead now. So what?
Xylophones killed her? What happened to Vicky?
You know, she just suddenly vanished. She just suddenly vanished as soon as you came into her life. You know that? It's weird, right?
Did zebras jump over her? Like, what happened to her? I thought Vicky was alive and well.
Always again, Vicky. Always, always. And I think you did something.
You think I did something? What exactly are you talking about?
Considering the facts that you came into my life, she just happened to be dead in my bed. Why do you think that? When you came knocking at my door at midnight the next morning, dead in the driveway.
Dear, I consider that a miracle.
Exceptional. You're exceptionally good at lying. Is this really what you want? Me? Because I don't think so.
For heaven's sake, what are you talking about? You don't think I want to?
God damn this. I can't be in this relationship anymore. You know, I found out all this stuff and you're a psychopath.
Hawaii was never my top choice for a vacation anyway.
And that's half of it. Now we're going to abandon the alphabet completely and have you guys have some fun here. We're going to play a little game, and Alicia, you're going to call this one? All right. So for Alexis and for Carrie, is it okay to say that they have a special day for you? Is that okay? It's her birthday today! Alexis and Carrie, they're going to do a scene, and Alicia is going to actually stop the scene at certain points and ask you guys to reshape the scene in a way that she thinks will make it more interesting. So you want to get all the input and everything? This game is called You Tell Us.
Let's have a relationship between these two. What is this relationship? How are they related? How do they know each other? They are on a Tinder date. Yes. All right. Here we go.
I can't believe we're meeting in person for the first time.
We've been talking. And
freeze. Why is it a bad time? Why is it a bad time to hear? There's a hurricane coming.
It was almost not going to be a good time, but you know what? I have to put the shutters up because Hurricane Daniel is on his way. And I just had to meet you. I had to meet you at least once.
Before we get swept away in the hurricane?
Of course. We could totally die, or
you don't need me to
the house could fail.
Help you with those shutters.
I
As a matter of fact, I could so use your help, Gwendolyn. All right. They're really, really heavy, heavy steel shutters.
All right. Show
Freeze.
Me the way.
How did Gwendolyn get so fit? What kind of fitness does she put in here?
CrossFit.
CrossFit. Gwendolyn has been really into CrossFit.
CrossFit level 6 teaches me to use others' bodies, and so I would love to use yours and, you know, help with these shutters.
I think that I would really, really appreciate your help.
Yes.
Putting my shutters
to unravel them again. I can do that.
I'll bet you can.
All right, so is this Hurricane Daniel really coming, or was this just an excuse to get me to your place?
It was just an excuse.
I knew it. I knew it.
I just
I
had
knew
to
it.
Meet you. What was she really wanting?
Maybe
she has an ex-boyfriend. And what does this ex-boyfriend do to Carrie that she wants Gwendolyn to protect her from? What did he do?
Oh, her ex-boyfriend stole her cat. She needs protection, and that's what she really wanted.
I totally made up the hurricane, Gwendolyn, honestly.
I hadn't seen anything on the weather, so... And it's not
Hurricane Daniel. It's my ex-boyfriend, Daniel. And he's such a bad guy, Gwendolyn. He...
I hate when men do that to my women! You tell me where he lives.
You stole my cat, but could you do that again?
I hate it. Where's that pussy? Grab me that little pussy. I hate when men do things to my women.
He totally stole my pussy, and he hasn't given it back.
Oh.
And that's you tell us. And now it's time for America's favorite game show, Jeopardy, with your host, Rick Trebek! Double Jeopardy. You guys are back from your commercial break. Now points are all going to be double this round, so double. So make sure you put your thinking caps on this time. That first round was a disaster, folks. Disaster. Let's first test your buzzers. They were a little faulty in the first half. Jonathan, please test your buzzer.
Alexis, this is the last time I'm going to tell you. Cut it out.
Pretty long for a buzzer, but we're going to go with that. Danielle, please test your buzzer. Can you test it again?
Why not?
Nice. And Mondo, please test your buzzer.
Jews for Jesus.
Whoa.
We should have run these by our censors for a second. Sorry. So we have your box audience that you provided us the answers for this round of Jeopardy. So let's see what these wonderful contestants can do this time around. Let's start with Open heart surgery.
Jews for Jesus.
Mondo.
What do you do when you go into the evangelical church?
It was in the form of a question. It was a run-on question, I guess. You get the point.
Alexis, last time I'm going to tell you, cut it out.
All right, yes, Jonathan, yes.
All right, let's, what's the answer?
Open heart surgery,
that's what you're telling me. Okay.
Yes, that's what I'm saying, that's what the audience is saying.
What is something I'm good at?
Mondo, you win somehow, miraculously.
Hail Lord, hallelujah!
Rick, come on, man, don't
be
bones.
Sorry, it's the judge. Cactus.
cactus?
Yes, Daniela.
What is why you wear blue?
Alexis, last time, cut it out. That wasn't a comment, that was a buzzer?
Yeah.
Okay, all right, yes, Jonathan, yes.
What is something that she uses in kinky foreplay?
I'm gonna give Jonathan the point.
All right, Rick, all right, Rick.
How
I'm
are you
glad.
Gonna give it to Jonathan?
Because he's sort of new.
He doesn't know what I use in my kinky foreplay.
Apparently okay. He does.
I think it's a safe assumption to make. She's a little on the wild side, okay, Rick?
Why,
does
I have
go,
a sword?
Go to the next answer.
Sword.
Go to the next answer, Rick.
That was Alexis.
Bob Saget. Bob Saget. Bob Saget. Yes, Danielle.
What is, who is my first boyfriend?
Seriously, Rick.
It's always possible. I mean, I heard he dated all the girls from Full House when he was on the show the first time around. So it's just... Yes, you get the point, Daniela. Next point. Bangladesh. 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 Sorry, Bangladesh. Bangladesh.
Alexis, last time I'm going to tell you, cut it out.
Yes, Jonathan.
Okay. Listen to this one. Okay.
Where was we got to hear him out, but I enjoy the buzzer. Thank you. Yes.
Don't interrupt me. I'm talking. I'm talking. Okay. Where was the last broad I slept with from?
She was from Bangladesh, or did you Bangladesh, or I'm not sure.
Tomato, tomato.
What do I do when I'm sitting behind my giving about sermon? I can't think of what I'm doing. I'm gonna Bangladesh.
Bangladesh, the dish, yes. That's what I do when my satellite
and
goes out too.
And I'm passing around
and
I collect money. Can I have some money? Anybody?
Okay, no.
You know, your points are zero. I mean, if you'd actually be better at the game, you actually wouldn't need the money. All right, let's do one more before we go to Final Jeopardy. Final Jeopardy, Don King. Well, that's a blast from the past. Don King. Don King. Don King. Don King. Don King?
Don King. Truth for Jesus.
Yes, Mondo.
What do we call the great Lord? Don King. All of our sins. Don King.
Works for me.
Don King.
You get the points. Yes, congratulations. All right, so now Final Jeopardy.
Jeopardy.
Put down your buzzers, folks. Thank you. You've had a great second round. Improved yourself somewhat. For your Final Jeopardy, it will be meatballs. Meatballs. Meatballs.
What is something I like to stuff in her mouth after this?
Meatball. And what did you wager?
Your family.
My family is not a wager.
Great. Okay. So I'm just saying, choose wisely, okay?
Okay, I feel the intimidation. I'm going to see what tipped over here. Daniela, what did you put for meatballs? What is your question answer?
What I do on the first date.
Meatballs. And what did you wager, Daniela?
A weekend with a salary. A Vegas salary.
I mean, it's like
I'm thinking about to
like
lose my
sink.
Family, Jonathan. Sorry. Mondo, you've been in first place the whole time.
What do I always say to my choir boys?
Oh my God, Rick. Rick, your family's on the line here, Rick.
I just saw the Spotlight movies. I'm going to take that for gospel. What was your wager?
Well, I wager a night out with my choir boys.
Rick.
Jonathan wins! Jonathan
Woo!
Wins!
Well, all right, your family's going to
check out now. And this is Jeopardy! We'll be right back. little game now where you actually get four scenes at the same time. It's pretty cool, so just follow along and let's see if they can keep up with you guys, the audience, the smarter audience. They're smarter than me, maybe not you guys, but they're smarter than me. Everyone's pretty smarter than me. So for Gabriella and for Sasha, let's get a, what is a, what's a sports team that has an unusual name? Bananas?
Banana slugs.
Wow, okay, right? For Sasha and for Jared, let's get, what's a board game you played growing up?
Sorry,
right? For Alexis and for Jared, let's get the last movie that you Netflixed.
Tammy.
Huh?
Tammy?
Okay, right? And for Gabrielle and Alexis, let's get a, let's get an unusual state.
Milwaukee.
That's pretty unusual, but yes, we'll go with Milwaukee all the same. So let's, right? Let's review.
Banana slugs.
Right?
Sorry.
Right?
Tammy.
Right?
Milwaukee.
Right? And this is Four Corners.
Hey, welcome to the pet store. I see you're interested in our banana slug selection.
Yeah, it's vast.
Yeah, we have a remarkable selection here. There are multiple colors from all over the world.
Yeah, so I'm preparing this meal for my mother-in-law, and I need some banana slugs to put in with meatloaf.
I am sorry. That's...
You know, just to add a little flavor, you know.
Yeah, these are more for...
Because she doesn't really... She doesn't really like me, and I want to impress her.
Pet store.
Right. But they're salty, you know. They add that extra flavor.
Okay. Can you tell me more? Tell me what kind of
rice.
Recipe?
Sorry about it.
Tell me.
Oh. You like it, Timmy?
I do, Johnny.
I've been hoping to impress you with my moves.
I'm impressed. You've been practicing.
I can't stop.
I know.
Right.
You can really just call me Tamara.
Tamara, what a beautiful name.
Thank you. Welcome to our establishment here.
Oh.
I really am happy that you made it all this way.
Well, Ukraine is very far.
Right. And so I'm Tamara, as I mentioned.
Tamara.
Beautiful. Tamara. And as I mentioned, I, you know, really want to make you feel as welcome as possible here.
You know, in Ukraine, we don't have pet stores.
Okay, so is that something you'd like to explore?
I would like to purchase the dog.
Right.
So the name of the musical is Milwaukee, and you now have the leading role as the coal miner from Milwaukee.
I can do it.
And we just thought you were a perfect fit. You know, there was many other girls that we had to choose from, but you...
Yes, because of my heritage.
Yes.
Right.
Exactly.
Ashes to ashes, they
exactly.
say.
Exactly.
You know.
Exactly.
I'm assuming.
You bring so much life to the character.
Okay. Is it this kind of emotion?
Exactly.
This kind of emotion?
And you have to sing this while you do it.
Okay. Give me the beat. Two. Three, four.
Right!
So I've been doing some research on recipes, and it turns out the Ukrainian banana slug is the best for what you're looking for.
Do you have crickets as well? I'm thinking maybe
you
like on the
are
side.
In luck. We
you know,
have
like
a
chocolate
large
covered,
large
or maybe.
Chocolate covered.
Well, you know, like we could do s'mores. We put it on with the marshmallow, mm-hmm. and then don't you think that would be good?
Yeah, your grandma is going to be thrilled.
I just wanted
to. Shazam!
So anyways, I'm gonna stop with the silly moves and just tell you that I like you.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry?
Yeah.
What? This is about to be a non-union dance off.
Right.
There are dogs for free at this place called The Pound.
The pound.
And we can get many puppies there.
You know, it's been my whole dream in my life to hold dog in my hand. Yes. All I did was watch American television and look at dogs.
Yes.
I lived in igloo in Ukraine.
Oh, I cannot even relate.
Tamara, you have no idea how hard it is.
Right.
We have this choreographer coming in to work with you.
That'll
and he does
be
a
wonderful.
Lot of like this.
Oh!
But he's really talented. Oh. He works in New York, he works in Chicago,
okay.
And so he's going to be the one who choreographs the show for us.
Okay, okay.
So if you could just, you know, loosen up a little bit.
Loosen up how loose are we?
I mean, he's pretty loose. He's just like. He's
I really
loose.
Am just better at lunges. Exactly. Is that going to be fine?
That's a good start. That's definitely a good start.
Left!
I'm so sorry I taught you. In Ukraine, we don't have filters.
Yes, I am aware. As long as...
Oh my God, I'm so... I wanted to say it out loud for the first time. I recorded it, and then it looked better than now what it's coming out. I'm sorry. I just love you, bro. I'm sorry.
Left.
Maybe you could come to dinner with me and you could pretend to be like my boyfriend and then maybe they would like me better. Do you think it would be really great just to have that emotional support at the dinner?
Well, okay, what's your grandmother like? Give me a background in this relationship. How long have we been dating? I'll be from Ukraine. You'd be from Russia.
Oh, that's a really good idea. Except my grandmother.
Yeah, she's not.
She's not going to go for that. Are we going to find diamonds in these mines?
I think that's a great addition. You know, the script is still, you know, under edit.
All right,
still
well,
working. There's this guy from Russia.
How I see
coming.
My. Oh, really?
Yeah, he wrote a book about Milwaukee.
Funny. So, are there gonna be dogs in this?
Yes, dog sled.
A dog sled. Okay, sound familiar.
Oh,
can you believe we're here at the pound? All these puppies are waiting for you.
I am flabbergasted that you walked with me. 4 blocks. So conveniently placed next to your own shops.
Yes, I like to get direct traffic that way. It helps. It helps with business.
Tamara, look.
Dog lovers.
You have been
and
a
tourists.
Oh. You know, you're very forward. In like in Ukraine, women do not approach the facial area.
So, and last more corner. Going, I need some emotions out there. Let me get some emotions, positive, negative, even stuff that may not even be technically emotions. I'm not very picky on a Tuesday night. Huh?
Sick.
Definitely not an emotion, but it'll work. All right, let's go on that vein. Let's keep going. Something else. Huh?
Depressed.
Anger. Anger.
Disgusting.
I see where you guys are at, and I don't like it. I don't like it for a student, so let's get some more positive emotions. Excited, yes, that's better.
Wowed.
Wowed.
Grateful.
Ambivalent. Ambivalent, okay, well that's splitting the difference, that'll work. Something else?
Anxious
and exhausted, that should be enough. Now I'm gonna get my two actors out here and they're gonna perform a scene, and somewhere along the way I'm gonna mix it up and then both of them will take on these emotions that you guys gave us. That's why this is called emotions. Let's bring out our two actors. Lisa back! Sorry. For Lisa and Isabella, let's get a relationship for the two of them. Sisters, you're sisters, and this is emotions.
I don't appreciate that you've been calling my husband so often. I don't call him. What are you talking about? I mean, I saw him call on the phone. And
hello, you know, it's your house phone. I'm calling you.
Yeah.
But
I
my
think
husband
doesn't see.
And you do too.
Hello! I actually picked up the phone, now that you say it's the house phone. I did pick up the phone when I was in our bathroom the other day. We didn't have a bathroom in there yet. I mean, a phone in there. And I picked it up and you guys were talking about taking a trip. Together.
What?
Alone.
Mm-hmm.
I think you're totally
going to
see
it. I would not take a trip with your husband alone.
Really?
Disgusted.
But since you're so jelly, it makes me not want to do shit for you.
A surprise party for me?
Forget the surprise.
My birthday's in December. We're planning ahead. It's going out of town.
You are in December.
Freeze, grateful.
You should be grateful.
A whole year ahead?
Just the fact that you got jealous is hilarious.
I'm just so glad you're taking my husband.
I mean, you've been so jealous of him.
He is on my nerves. Thank you so much.
Anger.
Sir. I don't want your husband. I guess you forgot I'm a
husband. No, you don't want my husband. You're taking my husband.
I'm not taking
your
husband.
You're taking him. I don't want him.
I don't want him either.
You're taking him.
Excited.
I don't like balls. Don't you get a bunch of girls now?
Ambivalent.
Whatever. I mean, girls, guys.
If you want to take him, just take him.
And that is emotion. For our next to last game for before the Improv 5 show, we play a little game that also like the one before, we'll mix things up, but this time it's not your input beyond just the initial stuff. Jared and Sasha, they're going to do a scene, and somewhere along the way we're going to mix things up and just force them to change, to up their ante. But to get started, let's get a location that would fit on the stage. Car. A car? A car would definitely fit on the stage. And this is... A three-seater? Okay, and this is New Choice.
Alright. Driving exam. Don't be nervous.
Oh my god.
I know it's your first time. Taking your test.
Woo!
Take your breath.
Car lows. I'm gonna put the keys down for a second and tell you that it's been a whole year since Mom left, and I have not been able to take this exam because I just can't get over how she drove away.
Samson, I can see how that would be scarring, but I'm paid by the hour, and
I don't have anyone else to talk to. I mean, every Wednesday I come here and I just like talk to you. New Choice. Every Wednesday I come here and I just pray. and you know, you're sitting next to me, and I just close my eyes and I pray and I go, Buddha, help me. And he does.
I am aware of your rituals, and I try to encourage you every week to speed this process along so we can get through the test.
It's very hot. Let me turn on the air conditioner.
Okay. That's the radio.
New Choice.
That's the speedometer.
New Choice.
That's the cassette player.
This Volvo 88. Gosh, it's very tight. I'm really appreciative, like I said, and I know I haven't even left the parking lot, but
the test is half over.
You're just like an awesome guy. God, I just. Like, feel your energy. It's like a yellow, bluish, orange. New Choice. It's like dinosaurs ate your head. New Choice. It's like I just threw a shoe at it and then 17 Chinese dudes came by.
That is my personality in a nutshell. My grandmother told me the same thing when I was a kid.
It was so tough, dude. Like, I threw my shoe and then I'm like, what? Asian dudes? And all they
did... Where are they all coming from?
They just took pictures of me.
They tend to do that.
Man, I'm so sorry. I just... Oh. Thank you.
We're gonna get started now.
Just hold on one second.
Okay.
Wow, your wrist is really thick.
I've been doing Kung Fu.
New Choice.
I have been doing another form of martial arts.
Another form of martial arts?
Yes.
Wow, you are... You know, if this car wasn't so tight, I would like to spread this leg. New Choice. I would yell to the wind and say, Papa, can you hear me? And that is New Choice.
To the end.
Stand up and incredible tonight. Yes. Now we're gonna play a little game called Medley, where we mix things up. First, let's get somebody's first job, an unusual first job. Maybe not even that unusual. What was your first job?
Scraping barnacles off the bottom of boats.
Scraping barnacles off the bottom of a boat. This is the world's worst barnacle scraper. World's worst.
Give me that axe!
Do they offer swimming classes around here?
I think I'm going to name my firstborn barnacle.
I'm completely terrified of water.
All right, now let's get a job that you really like. Something maybe you wanted to do when growing up, when you were a kid, you wanted to be growing up and make it happen. Maybe it didn't happen. What's that dream job you always had? Trapeze? World's worst trapeze artist. Do not hurt yourself.
I'm really afraid of heights.
I think my vertigo's acting up again.
Now, when you flip, don't hold on to my hands. Just air it or something.
They call me Butterfingers, so.
All right, so let's get something that happened in history, a historical event. Maybe about a few weeks ago, maybe it happened a few years ago, maybe a few centuries ago. Something that happened in history. They invented beer. These are things you never hear at the invention of beer.
Hops suck. Alright. I'm just so at peace. I feel so good. I do not need anything to make me happy.
Okay, line up the cup.
Scratch it. I don't think this is going to be a good idea.
How many calories are in this?
All right, so raise your hand if you're going somewhere interesting this summer. It's obviously summer. We're all planning. Some of us are planning vacations. Going somewhere interesting this summer. Italy? All right. Italy. These are things you never hear in Italy.
The men here are so hideous looking. Pasta con la pasta! Oh, I could never eat here again.
You just don't whistle at the girls. French fries.
Okay, Jessica, let's get some blank red, some little sultry light stuff. What is something, a little lower on the remotes, I think, is what would be in order there. More Blitzkrieg, less bop. Let's get a... what's something that reminds you of your childhood? Nintendo. I heard Nintendo. These are... This is double entendre Nintendo.
I like my men the way I like my Nintendo. Long cable attached.
I like my women like I like my Nintendo. We play good games.
I like my men like I like my Nintendo. Always work better after you. You know. Oh, I like my men like I like my Nintendo. Finger on the I like my men like I like my Nintendo. Can play all night and doesn't turn off.
I like my men how I like my Nintendo. A guy named Luigi and another one named Mario.
You go to the supermarket, let's be more specific, you go into Walmart and you're checking out through 10 items and under, but there's that 11th item you accidentally got and like you want to leave it behind. What's that one item you really don't care whether you buy or not? What is that?
Tampons.
I heard tampons. What else did I hear? Huh? Plunger, let's go Plunger. It's almost related. Plunger, double entendre.
I like my men the way I like my plunger. Good at cleaning out the pipes.
I like my men like I like my plunger, with a long handle.
I like my men like I like my plunger. Good suction.
Thank you. I like my men like I like my plunger. Able to get a hold of them when I call.
I like my women how I like my plungers. Able to hold a big load and preferably black.
I like my men like I like my plunger. Pump, 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 pump it real good.
I like my women like I like my plungers. In the garage and there when I need it.
I like my men like I like my plunger. Once they're dirty, you just gotta rinse them off a little bit. I like my men or my women the way I like my plunger. With a little poop around the rim.
We're gonna have to end on that.